Good morning, students, class 7. Today is your second session of GK. So we have done so far page number 16 and 17. For that, I taken you to the trip towards, trip to complete Indian periphery locations. So for further on this subject, again, I need to do the complete tourism to all the parts of India, especially northeastern states. In that way, I'm going to make you trip all through. So here we start with, I'm going to share the screen with you with a map and see it carefully. Yes, over here, everyone, please pay attention now, India travel. As you can see, first of all, on the north side is this Jammu and Kashmir, then it is Chandigarh, then it is Himachal Pradesh. You can see all these states. And Punjab, then Uttarakhand over here, sharing border with Nepal. Then in between Haryana. Haryana is in India only, purely in India. It is sharing boundaries with Punjab, your Rajasthan, and Delhi is also falling away. It's the UT. Then your Haryana is also sharing border with UP also. Then coming down, we go towards the Gujarat. After Rajasthan, it's your own state. Rajasthan is sharing border with your Gujarat as well. Fine. And Rajasthan is sharing border with Pakistan also towards the Thar Desert. It's in Jaisalmer. Okay, if you have been to that place, students who all have been to that place, they must be knowing very well that Rajasthan is sharing border with the Pakistan also. So in 1971 war, actually this border played a vital role. Fine. 21 Sikh was deployed over there to safeguard the boundary, to safeguard. And that movie, you know, border movie is made on this subject only. Then the heart of the country, that is MP, it's in the heart. It's just in the center. That is why it's called Madhya. Madhya meaning center. Okay. And it's sharing Gujarat, and MP is sharing border with Maharashtra. And here are UTs, Daman and Diu, Dadar and Nagar Haveli. Yes. Now coming down, Maharashtra is sharing border with your Goa and your Karnataka. Then your Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh is further divided into two parts. You know that, Telangana and Andhra. Then Karnataka over here, the capital city of Karnataka is the Silicon Valley of India, that is Bangalore. Then Tamil Nadu, fine, the capital city is Chennai. Then Kerala, the capital is Thiruvananthapuram. And downwards is Sri Lanka, which is not shown in this map, in the previous map I showed you. And Puducherry is a UT, which is on the boundary line of Tamil Nadu. Fine, it's a coastal place. Auroville is a very famous place in Puducherry. It is Sir Aurobindo Ghosh place. Fine, there's an ashram over there. Gandhi Marg, that is Gandhi Beach. Some coastal beaches are named after some great legendary people. That is in Puducherry only. Fine. Now coming to the most important, this is, I mean, according to your lessons, this Chhattisgarh, it's a mineral area. It's totally mines are found over here. Orissa also, Jharkhand also. Then your Andhra Pradesh, I taught you. If you go towards, yes, then it's Bihar also sharing border with Nepal, and Uttar Pradesh also sharing border with Nepal. And on that range only, this West Bengal lies toward the east. It is called East Pakistan also. And now the Seven Sisters, this is the area of Seven Sisters. Okay, it is sharing border with Bhutan somewhere here. Then your Myanmar over here, then your Bangladesh over here. And then that goes towards your Bay of Bengal. Okay, so this Arunachal Pradesh, that is the largest state, largest in terms of area of northeastern states. Okay, Assam, it is the gateway towards northeast. Why? Because we do get straight flights towards Assam. And the capital is Guwahati, which is, you can say, the biggest metropolis of northeast. That is the most urbanization. And Assam is connected with your West Bengal. If you see carefully, it is. So Bangla is also spoken in Assam, if you see. And there is one very holy place, Kamakhya Temple, Kamakhya Devi Temple. That is in Assam only, okay, near to Guwahati. Then Meghalaya, that is the Scotland of the east. And that is Shillong is the capital city. Beautiful place, you know, beautiful weather out there. Entire northeast is very green, and it is beyond your imagination because people out there are quite English, very modern, very stylish people. Nagaland, then Manipur, you can see the Mizoram. Then here is Tripura, sharing border with Bangladesh, I told you. I am revising all these things so that you should have a complete knowledge of these seven sisters. Generally, students, they tend to forget it. This is called Northeastern path, okay? And Buddhism is followed over here. Christianity is followed over here. Completely Chinese culture is being followed over here. People out there are very English, very style. And Nagaland has great history. While the Second World War, you know, the way we got India got free, it has a vital role. Now you will be wondering how. You have to find it out by browsing at your own, Google at your own, how it is important. I just ignite the spark of it that you should know, right? So this is my set for the cartography of India, Northeastern state. Please do remember all these things because all these states are now being covered in your upcoming lessons, okay? Now, coming on to your... Okay, now coming up with your lessons, I'm going to display that on the screen and I will tell you the answers also, okay? Now, sharing screen of lessons. Just a sec, I think... there is certain some problem. Let me switch back. Okay. Okay. Now, share screen. Yes, here we go. Fine. Here we go. This one, page number 18. I'm coming today after the page number 18. Fill in the blanks with the correct answers. Dash is a product of Northeastern region that received the first GI tag through the Indian Patent Office. Okay, first GI tag through the Indian Patent Office. What is the product name? The product name is your Darjeeling tea. Okay, and I'm going to tell you what is your GI tag. Okay, well, GI tag, I'm going to explain you now. Okay, fine. Yes, GI tag is, now listen to me, all my dear students, please. GI tag is your geographical indication. Fine, geographical indication tag is basically our measure which defines the region of origin of a food or agricultural produce. The tags were given under the Act of Geographical Indications of Goods. Okay, and that is under the Act 1999. Fine, so this is geographical indication tag to your Darjeeling tea. Fine, the Darjeeling tea is quite famous in Assam. Now the next is, Dash in the Tinsukia district of Assam is the home of Asia's first and oldest oil refinery. Dash in the Tinsukia. This place is called Digboi. This we are going to study in the geography as well. Digboi in the Tinsukia district of Assam is the home of Asia's first and oldest oil refinery. The third one is Dash, also known as the Chicken's Neck, is the smallest narrow corridor in West Bengal connecting the seven sisters states with the rest of India. Dash, also known as Chicken's Neck. You can imagine what the Chicken's Neck is, fine? So the answer for this is Siliguri Corridor. Siliguri Corridor is known as the Chicken's Neck. It's a small narrow corridor in West Bengal connecting the seven sisters. West Bengal, I told you, it's a very important place, West Bengal. Through that, the flights basically fly towards the northeastern region from Kolkata only, right? West Bengal, capital city, Kolkata, city of joy. From there only, the connectivity is good. I mean, there's no straight flight. Hardly you will get any straight flight from Jaipur. There is no straight flight towards the northeast. So you have to go to Delhi. From Delhi, it hops to the West Bengal and then to the northeast, okay? Now, Dash is the first rail cum road bridge over River Brahmaputra. River Brahmaputra flows through Assam. You know, it comes from China. The answer for this is Saraighat Bridge. The name is Saraighat Bridge. It is given over here, Saraighat Bridge. You can tally the spelling also while noting it down. Coming on to the fifth, That is the largest of the northeastern states, Arunachal Pradesh. Area-wise, Arunachal Pradesh is the largest state. Okay, though it is at the extreme of northeast, if you can see on the map, bilkul sabse last mein ja karke Arunachal Pradesh sharing border with China, complete Chinese, you know, they're the eating pattern, their wearing pattern, the clothing pattern, English people out there, very stylish, but completely Chinese culture, okay? So Arunachal Pradesh, that's how you can correlate, and you need to remember. Area-wise, that is the biggest. Otherwise, area-wise, the largest state in India is your Rajasthan, your own homeland, okay? Feel proud that you are the natives of this land. Now, the next question, name the common group of these northeastern states. Now, over here, the first, you can see the group is of all Olympians, okay? Mary Com, she went for Olympics, Deepak Amarkar, then Somadev Devaraman. So these are all Olympians. You will fit with Phil that these are the categories of Olympians. Then Muga silk, I discussed about it in my last class, that is the Assamese silk, right? Part also, Eri silk is also in northeastern part also. There is a proper video of Eri silk. You can wash it also, it's quite washable. And it is the silk which is purely organic. Otherwise, you have to kill silkworms, you know. Silkworms are killed while the process. So I'm telling you this additionally. While making Muga silk or Pat silk, you know, the silkworms are being killed. You know, they boil the water in order to dig out the silk from the cocoons. You can see the process of making silk. That is your assignment now, sideways. I will give you certain assignments also in order to just, you can say, enrich your knowledge. So Eri silk ka bhi video is out there. It's on Brat India. You can say it is like if it in the process of making erythrin, there is no process of killing the worm. Okay, there's something different process, even I don't remember, but I have seen it, so I know that this is pure, this is purely organic erythrin. So this comes under the category of your what we say asin silk, okay, asin silk, pat, munga, and erythrin. Now, third, this Bhutia, Nishi, Bodo. Right, these are all tribes. Bhutia, Nishi, Bodo tribes. Okay. Then if you come to Nagaland, Meghalaya, Mizoram, all these are formerly part of Assam, then it was further divided. Right? It was further divided. This is again addition to your knowledge that this Naga, Meghalaya, and Mizoram, these three were also the part of Assam. Then further on, I mean later on, they got divided in their own independent states. Okay, now, next question, better let me check whether it is being recorded or not, because, yes, it is being recorded. Name the northeastern states connected with each of the following cultural features, okay? This you can say, easily you can say these are the tribal dressing, the way they are dressed up, that is a very tribal sort of style. So this is Puanchi, traditional women's garment. Okay, so the answer for this is they all belong to your Mizoram. Okay, this is Mizoram, answer is Mizoram. Now the second is Tawang Monastery, that is in Arunachal Pradesh. I told you complete Chinese and China, they follow Buddhism. So completely this place is filled with your monasteries, okay? The place where they worship is called monastery. Buddhism is, you can say the holy place of Buddhism is called monastery. Largest monastery in India is your Tawang Monastery. Beautiful place if you see the videos of it, fine, or travel and tourism. If you come across, you'll see, you'll find that the place is very beautiful, very scenic place. Now, the third is traditional dance, as you can see, Sangrai. This dance is, I believe, it is your Tripura. Sangrai is the dance in Tripura. Okay, so Tripura. And now handmade forts is handmade from aerial roots of rubber trees, living root bridges. Bridges are made out of roots. You know, as you can see, it is the wettest place of India. That is Meghalaya. I told you in my last class also, wettest place. Highest rainfall is being received in this place, and the place which in particular receives the highest rainfall. Earlier it was Cherrapunji, now it is Mansingram. Okay. Now the fifth, coming on to the fifth, Hornbill Festival, named after a large colorful forest bird. Fine. The name hornbill is name of the forest bird. And let me tell you, for dictionary for knowledge, if you have your brother and sister in class 12, you can ask them what's the name of their book, hornbill only. Okay, this festival that lasts for a week or 2 weeks so in Nagaland, hornbill festival is celebrated in Nagaland. Even our honorable prime minister also witnessed his prime minister before COVID. Now, the sixth one is Satriya, major Indian classical dance. Major Indian classical dance, that is Assam. This dance is basically based in order, to glorify Lord Krishna. Assamese dance are basically to glorify Lord Krishna. So Satriya dance is to glorify Lord Krishna. Fine. This is a depiction of, you can say, opera also. With some movements, like some drama is going on, opera is the other form of drama in a musical form. Fine. So Satriya is that sort of a dance. So beautiful dance, beautiful culture, beautiful Northeast, and Northeast is safe as well. And I think so, I've imparted a lot of stuff to you. And more, the assignments which I have given you all through this way of my journey towards teaching you these two pages, please do follow that. Try to browse more on it. It's going to help you in great deal, beta. So that's why it's my small effort for you in order to inculcate the interest towards the Northeastern state and how it is located on a map. You must know from how to reach there, the routes also. Fine. Try to browse more and more. You have good amount of time to enrich yourself. So thank you so much. Yes, thank you so much for the day. I hope you enjoyed the session. Fine. I will come up with more good inputs, more productive inputs for you. Till then, goodbye. See you next week. Plus, be regular, update your work in your books sideways. If you have not purchased a book, go and purchase a book, because the market is open right from the early morning time till 11 o'clock. So do buy those, and please update and open your books along with my videos. So that you should enjoy also, okay? And enjoy map reading and do quiz with your siblings also. Right, map ka bahut acha, like I remember during my studies, we used to do a lot of quizzes, you know. Ye place kahan par hai, speciality batao. So keep learning, keep doing. And I have a competition with your parents also, with your friends also, even on Google Meet, or if it's a Zoom session also, you can conduct a quiz, you know. Try to be innovative to learn things. Because if you're not being tested with each other, the completeness will not come of the concept. I'm telling you, learning, understanding at your own, but the right way of that your knowledge should be conveyed is being tested. For doing the testing, you can conduct quizzes on your, you can say Google Form, you can connect, you can make a group, and you can do the quiz amongst your friends, with your siblings also. And now, since because of internet and technology connectivity, this digital connectivity has made the thing so easy that any friend of yours sitting in other state or any other country, you can all connect to have such games between you, okay? Amongst yourself, between what two people amongst, that means in a group. And it's going to help you. This is just an idea I've shared with you so that you should learn, okay? Thank you so much, Vita. God bless you all and take care.